Hello everyone, welcome back to Mars, and welcome back to ElderFox Documentaries. We were so happy with the response of our first 4K Mars video that we decided to do it again, as there are still so many places for you to explore. Again, the images are real, taken by NASA rovers, directly from the surface of the planet. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. There are some bonus clips at the end which are truly mind-blowing. This image was captured over the period of several days in April of 2020 by the Curiosity rover, which is still climbing Mount Sharp. The strange feature is known as the green hue pediment and forms an overhanging ledge. The wider area has gained the name the clay-bearing unit due to the large amount of clay found here, which tells the story of how this area was shaped by water in the past. Towards the top of the image, we can see the bottom of Gale Crater, where Curiosity started its journey in 2012. Here we can see the informally named Spirit of St. Louis Crater, named after the first solo non-stop flight over the Atlantic by Charles Lindbergh. He named his plane the Spirit of St. Louis to recognize the financial backing for his flight from St. Louis residence. This image was taken by the now-retired Opportunity rover back in 2015. This area was thought to be too hazardous for Curiosity to pass. The wind-blown ripples and the steep ground where ripples are lacking are both poor terrain for the rover to cross. The team at NASA ended up taking a different route for the rover, which is out of the shot. These mosaics have been stitched together by NASA and its partners, sometimes from thousands of smaller images, and the black areas you may sometimes see are where no image was taken. We could zoom in so you don't see those areas, but then you wouldn't be seeing Mars in true 4K. We feel that it's important to limit the zoom to 4K quality. A question often asked is, who is standing on Mars to take a picture of Curiosity? Although this looks like an image taken by some sort of Martian, it is actually the result of dozens of exposures taken by a camera on the rover's robotic arm. The arm is then digitally removed from each image before they are stitched together in the usual way. This provides the engineers at NASA with a clear view of Curiosity to check that it is still operating as it should. This image is possibly the best ever taken from Mars, captured by the Curiosity rover in 2018 after climbing a steep Martian ridge. It is an excellent vantage point. This mosaic contains the rover's full journey, right from where it began at the bottom of the Gale Crater. In the distance is the northern rim of the crater. The ridge Curiosity is sitting on was given the name VERA Rubin Ridge, named after the late American astronomer Vera Rubin, who spent her life making astounding new discoveries and advocating for women in astronomy and science. This image is actually all the way back from 2006, but processed more recently in 2012. Taken by the now-retired Spirit rover, it presents Mars in approximate true color. In other words, if you were to stand on Mars, you would likely be seeing this sort of rusty environment. The Spirit rover stopped contacting NASA in 2010 after becoming trapped in a sand dune. Another panorama taken by Spirit shows the rover's tire tracks as it performs a series of maneuvers. Traversing the Martian landscape can be tough, but the rovers do have help at hand. NASA's orbital probes can fly above the sites and mark a safe path. In this image, the Opportunity rover is actually visible. Can you spot it? Okay, let us help. Strictly, this is not 4K, but we will zoom in just to spot the little rover. Do you see it now? This is the view of Victoria Crater from the ground, taken by Opportunity. Opportunity covered a total distance of over 45 kilometers on the Martian surface and is regarded as one of NASA's most successful missions. This image, taken in 2014, is presented in false color to highlight the rover's tracks as it climbed up a ridge. Curiosity is also hailed as a roaring success and is still actively climbing Mount Sharp. This photo was taken on the way to the base of the mountain. Despite the global pandemic, the little rover continues to explore. Some might say it is the best example of social distancing. Also, as far as we know, Mars is the only planet to be inhabited solely by robots. The sometimes unfavorable terrain on Mars presents a real danger for the rovers. Deep sand, steep climbs, and rocky terrain all provide challenges. Curiosity was built with these threats in mind. With 6 independently powered wheels, the rover is designed to withstand a tilt of up to 45 degrees. However, not wanting to take unnecessary risks, the team at NASA programmed the rover to avoid tilting more than 30 degrees through its hazard avoidance software. This image was taken in the Murray Buttes region by Curiosity. The butte stands at around 16 feet, or roughly 5 meters. We have now shown you all the mosaics that are possible to render in 4K. But here are some astonishing things you have to see. From this point, the footage is not 4K, but highly worth your time. In 2015, Curiosity captured this stunning true color image of a Martian sunset. Sunsets on Mars are actually blue in color, unlike the red ones we have here on Earth. Scientists believe that the fine particles of the Martian atmosphere permit more blue light than here on Earth when the sun is at this angle. The bright evening star in this image is actually the planet Earth. Captured by Curiosity, it is the first time that Earth has been pictured from the surface of another world. Opportunity spots a dust devil in this image, which are really common on Mars. They are actually beneficial to the solar-powered rovers, helping to remove dust from their solar panels. The rovers experience boosts in power after dust devils pass them. They have been spotted from orbit several times and leave eerie tracks on the ground. The Perseverance rover is scheduled to land in 2021. This series of images taken by Curiosity as it landed has been put together by NASA into a small video. The landing sequence is often called 7 minutes of terror, because it takes 7 minutes for the landing to take place, yet it takes 14 minutes for the signal to get back to Earth. So by the time NASA receives the signal that the craft has entered the atmosphere, the landing has either been a success or has failed. Click here to see how NASA lands these rovers on Mars and what Perseverance will do when it gets to Mars. If you enjoyed this video, please share it with everyone you know. We have to get these great achievements in front of as many people as possible.